This crowd is ready as we get set for the World Series. Game one is next. Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. The World Series on MLB The Show coming up. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. John Shambi alongside Chris Singleton. There may be no better atmosphere in all of baseball than game one of the Fall Classic, Singy. Lots of excitement to get this thing started.
Yeah, and the players feel that just as much as the fans. You're down there with goosebumps, and these guys are just trying to stay in the moment. But I'll tell you, for the home team especially, it's so hard not to be emotional and hyped up with all the energy in this building right now.
And on the other side, of course, you're looking to swing home field advantage your way with an all-important opening win on the road. First pitch coming your way next. So just about set now. And on the hill for the Dodgers, Michael Kopech. What should we keep an eye on here?
They're going to start this one with the opener because of the matchups. Very favorable. I think we're going to see him empty the tank with really good fastball velocity to try to retire these first three hitters.
Now it's going to be Gleyber Torres. And a foul ball. The next pitch misses, and one and one. A sliding stop. Throw to first. Nicely done for the out. As we take a look now at the New York Yankees lineup. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team, and I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, a big series.
Juan Soto, batting with one down, takes a strike. One down, base is empty. Inside corner, that's called a strike.
0-2 count, both pitches on the inside part of the plate. Hitter is thinking, I don't want to get beat here. This is a good time for something off speed away.
And the righty deals. Inside, almost got him. The pitch. That one is absolutely belted. Could be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And the first hit of the World Series is a double.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive in the center field.
One down, and next for New York, Aaron Judge. First pitch just misses.
Well, if they could push one across here in the first inning, would really settle the crowd down and help take that element out of the game early.
The pitch. That one way outside, and it's 2-0. Kopech, one of the best strikeout pitchers in the game, and that certainly is a benefit to him when he's in a spot like this. That one misses. Three balls, no strikes.
Yeah, if you're going to be in the game in high leverage situations, you've got to be able to get the swing and miss and put hitters away.
And ball four, and Judge takes his walk.
That just came apart right there. Four pitch walk, and the guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. Sliced hard, but foul. Runners at first and second with one gone here in game one. Fouled off. He was late.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
The pitch. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. Right through there for a strike. Two on, two outs. To the right side, Taylor. To first. And that is the third out of the inning. Yanks strand a pair. The Dodgers coming up, and we are scoreless. This is the World Series on the show. Back here with my pal Siggy. And on the hill, the lefty, Carlos Rodon. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel. That can make life very difficult on his opponents.
We go to the bottom of the first, and now here's the veteran DH, Kevin Kiermaier. As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers.
Count 1-0.
And the 1-0. And another ball. Breaking ball in there for a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Fastball for a strike. Bounce that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Kicks and fires. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner win. With two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here's Mookie to hit. On the ground to Jazz. Mookie retired, two down.
Batting third.
Time now for Dave Roberts' lineup for the Los Angeles Dodgers. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
That one drifts inside.
I think it's very important to establish the inside part of the plate early. It sets the tone for the rest of the game.
The wind of the pitch. Strike on the inside corner.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
Way high. Two outs, base is empty. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
He got away with one there, but he knows he can't go into that spot very often against a guy like this.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
So a man aboard, and now the shortstop, Tommy Edman. That clips the corner. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first here in game one of the World Series. And now the lefty, center field, Torres makes his way towards it, brings it in with a nice running grab. And that's the inning. First frame of the night behind us, and it's nothing nothing. Back here at Chavez Ravine, here's the veteran first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
The 1-1.
The hitting's going to come around. He's going to figure it out. But right now, his big asset is the way he plays the game on defense.
Another 1-2. 99 miles per hour to finish him off. Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. That one fouled off. Fouled off left side. The drama always heightened in the postseason, and it leads to some really special moments. Comes on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, when you do the same pitch back to back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
Two outs, base is empty. Austin Wells stepping in now for the Yankees. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away.
Well, one special postseason memory for me, Boog, was facing Pedro Martinez game five of the ALDS in Oakland. And, man, hit a double off the wall. Great feeling for a guy who would eventually go into the Hall of Fame.
Next pitch is outside. Right through there for a strike. Second inning here, no score. In there at the knees. Two and two now.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end, trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Left-hand hitter waits. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Here's Alex Verdugo. And first offering is fouled off. That's to third. What a stop from his backside. Got him. Nice play. One left for the Yankees. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And we're back. And now the first baseman, Max Muncy. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
And a pitch. Oh, he doesn't get the call. And it's 1-0.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
And the slider just misses.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Next offering in there for a strike. And a count 2-1.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit.
The 2-1. Chopper right side. Throw on to Rizzo. They get the out on Muncy.
Batting fifth. The third baseman. Kike.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Game one of the World Series here tonight, and all he's hoping is that the success that he's had in the first couple of rounds continues.
The great thing, you're here in the World Series. Now just try to have fun. The performance has been outstanding, and why should it stop now?
How do they cool him off?
Well, they're going to be extremely careful with him. I doubt he's going to get much to hit today, but when he does, be careful because he can hit it a long way.
Gary Simmons has the plate duty in this one.
Well, with Simmons, it's not always your standard strike zone, Boog. It kind of gives a little extra in some parts of the zone and then can be tighter in others. But I think the important thing is he doesn't get labeled as inconsistent, so you got to stay ready up there.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Makes the grab, and there's two gone. Yeah, one of those umpires, you just have to know what to expect, right?
Exactly.
Andy Pajas steps to the plate for the Dodgers. That's down and in. That one finds the zone. One ball, one strike.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
Two down, nobody on. On the ground to third. Jazz tosses the first, and the Dodgers are set down in order. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here at Dodger Stadium. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. Gleyber Torres up to the plate. Now the right-hander ready to go. Still no score. Torres goes 6'1", hitting leadoff in today's game. And he was born in Venezuela. Next pitch is outside. And another ball.
And that's a pitch early in this game. He needs to call for a strike. Struggling with command issues. He's got to get a little help from the umpire.
Fastball for a strike. And he deals. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Juan Soto now doubled his first time up. Immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
You know, these Yankees did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They worked three walks already, so that proves they're not anxious up there. They're sticking to their game plan, and it's working.
And here it comes. High fly ball down the left field line. And that is a foul ball. Nobody out, runner at first.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
That one way inside.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at bat. I'm sure there's some times where pitchers would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste six or seven pitches on one hitter.
Battling here as he fouls it away.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. They get the out on Soto. And there's one down.
The batter, the center fielder, Aaron Judge.
Here comes Aaron Judge. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. So far, the playoffs have not been kind to him. But tonight, a chance to start anew.
So much of this game is mental. He's just got to tell himself, I'm here. I've worked hard all year. Go out, have fun. Trust your ability.
You know, Shaggy, there's some people that say they feel more pressure actually in the league championship series than the World Series because they know this is it.
I could totally see that because, you know, you get to the World Series, that's what your whole goal was the entire season. Then you're there. There can be some luck involved, so you just got to shake it off, go out there, know that this is a rare opportunity, and just play your best.
Next offering way off the plate. And he delivers outside. Here comes a pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Torres over at first with one away. Gets a piece and stays alive. The 2-2. And there's the ball. Struck right field. That one back there. And it is gone. Aaron Judge leaves the yard. And that gives him a lead. It's 2-0. He kept swinging and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog. And he just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. Scary for a pitcher when a guy can take a fastball down the middle and hit it to the opposite field. No holes in a swing like that, and that time that ball was hit hard.
Base is empty, one away. Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now. In the air, left field. Under it. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
The third base is number 13. Jazz.
Two outs, bases empty. Jazz Chisholm Jr. stepping in now for the Yankees. Grounded out his first time up. Misses outside, and that's ball one. Bases empty, two away, but two runs are in. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Next offering is in for a strike. Right through there for a strike. A little bit high. The count now 2-2.
It's a good take.
Popped up foul territory behind the plate. Makes the catch in and over. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the Yankees 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Back here in L.A. as we go to the last of the third. The batter now will be Will Smith. Rodon back to work. That one ripped but foul.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Just off the outside edge, and the count is 1-1. Ground ball, Rizzo picks it up. He steps on the bag. One up, one down.
Batting ninth. The second baseman, Brett.
Just Taylor down. Fastball for a strike. It's 0-1.
There it was. Here it is. Hit it. He gets a take, gets ahead in the count.
Out to short. Whips it across. And two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third.
Now back, the designated hitter, Kevin Kiermaier.
Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Here's Kiermaier now. Struck out swinging, leading off the bottom of the first. And that's too high. Off the plate, and now 2-0. That one missing low.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if they'll walk you.
Mookie Betts hitting on deck circle. Fastball for a strike. Gets him to chase after that one.
Two strikes to a guy who's already 0-for-1 with the punch out. The only guy in the lineup with that strikeout. But you can't get too relaxed. You still got to make good pitches to get him out.
The lefty fires. Hit hard on the ground to short. Volpe throws to first in time. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Dodgers go down quietly, and they're down 2-0. They hand the ball over to a new arm, Shohei Ohtani.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. His first at bat was a strikeout.
Rizzo.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Ripped, but it curls foul. And a pitch. And down on strikes he goes. That's the first out in the top of the fourth. Anthony Volpe now at the plate. Struck out swinging his first time. Not even close there. And that is ball one. Line drive. And that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And that's a two-bagger.
A little more backspin on that instead of the top spin. And he's jogging around the bases rather than pulling up at second.
At second with one away, and stepping in for the Yankees, Austin Wells. Pitch misses, 1-0. Man at second. This one lifted in the air, left field. Hernandez settles underneath it. He's got it. There's two away. Oh, the throw is wild. Here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. He's 0 for 1. Verdugo. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. Ohtani, he's kind of a prototypical bullpen arm in today's game. Electric stuff that results in a ton of strikeouts in a tough spot like this. That is a big time benefit. Runner at second, two down. Top half of inning number 4. And that one fouled off.
Now, as a hitter, when a guy like this comes into the game, you feel like he's standing on top of you, and it's just attack mode coming right at you, expecting to get a swing and miss.
Man on second, two down. Got hit by him, no runs, one hit, a double, no errors, and one man left. And midway in the fourth, it's the Yankees 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Game one of the World Series. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Mookie Betts. And the pitch. A one down. Hard hit, right side. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And Betts is set down.
No left field.
And now Teoscar Hernandez. That one fouled hard the other way. One down, base is empty. And that's outside, and it's 1-1. The Dodgers still looking for their first hit in this one. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Missed with a changeup. Now 2-2. Wouldn't chase that time. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And it's a double. Their first hit in this one.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Great hands on that swing to take the inside pitch and drive it into the gap for the double. It's easy to spit off a pitch like that, Bogan. Can pull that thing foul, but that was perfect.
And here comes Tommy Edman, a switch hitter batting right.
Ball one, no.
In the dirt, blocked. Tag save. He's in the third of the wild pitch. Behind with that swing. It's strike one.
Ooh, Baya. You gotta remember to take the donut off the bat, partner.
One away with a runner at third. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Ground ball to the right side. Fires over to first, but they cut it to one as the run comes in.
Nice at bat right there. Puts the ball in play and brings in a run from third. Now they only trail by one.
Muncy digs in. He's 0 for 1.
Muncy.
That pitch clips the outside corner. That's strike one. Right through there for a strike.
If you're not ready for that pitch, you're just going to swing and miss or pop it up, waste the at bat. You're going to let it go. You better be ready to swing it.
Outside. Now 1-2. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And that will end the inning. One run, one hit, no errors, and nobody left on. We've played four. It's the Yankees 2 and the Dodgers 1. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top five, John Schaube with Chris leading Singleton. Off. And leading it off, Gleyber Torres. And a pitch. Right through there for a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Lake Trinan looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Brazier getting cranked up as well. Here's the 0-2. Ball one,
ball,
there.
Two strikes.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. Good eye right there.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Righty delivers. Swing and a ball popped up. And Gleyber Torres retired. And there's one down.
Now that designated hit. Juan Soto.
And now it's Juan Soto. 1-2. That's ball off the mark, and yeah, that's ball one. One out, base is empty. And two another ball.
Two-0 count, you really don't want to give in here. You've got to work the edges, really execute a pitch. Hopefully you can get back into this count.
And that's in for a strike. That's outside. And that's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Runner on at first with one gone. Aaron Judge at the plate. He's already homered in this game. And that one clips the corner.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. Another homer. His second home run of the game, and they add to their lead. It's 4-1.
That's a swing that'll boost the win probability for sure. There was a cutter away. Kind of works like a slider. You've got to stay on it, let it travel a little bit, and then get your arms extended. Really good piece of hitting right there.
One out, base is empty. And up next for New York, Giancarlo Stanton. Outside low, and it's 1-0. Two runs across in the inning, and we're at the top of the fifth. Next offering in there for a strike. And the count even at 1. And that's downstairs and outside. the 2-1. Swing and a foul straight back. One down, base is empty. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one.
Oh, you got to be pretty quick with the bat speed these days. So many guys throwing in the upper 90s, and you see the velocity on that one. Just tough to catch up to. I mean, guys are coming in, and they're going max effort. They're not looking to go a long distance. They want to get as many strikeouts as they possibly can.
Chisholm at the plate for the third time as he comes up empty there. Swings and misses, and it's nothing in two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
And now one and two.
Executed that pitch very nicely, just missed with it.
And another ball. Lifted in the air right center field. And makes the play, and that's out number three. Two runs on one hit, the two-run homer. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Yankees 4 and the Dodgers 1. Back here at Chavez Ravine, we head to the bottom of the fifth. It's Kike Hernandez.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot. You know, these Dodgers just aren't putting great swings on the baseball in this one. The good news is they're putting balls in play, but the bad news is most of them have been on the ground for easy outs. Nothing is finding a hole at all. They're having a real hard time elevating the baseball.
Rodon ready. Here comes.
Ball two.
Misses, and that's ball three. Payoff pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
On the ground to Jazz. Zips it to first, and that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
The center fielder, number 34, Andy.
Andy Pajes steps to the plate for the Dodgers. First time up, he grounded to third. And a foul ball. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Next offering is in for a strike.
Oh, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Two gone. And up to the plate is Will Smith. Grounded out his first time. And that one is lifted in the air. Brings it in for the third out. So they make short work of them there. Five innings complete. The Yankees 4 and the Dodgers 1. Now on the bump, Lake Trinan.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And here is Anthony Rizzo, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts.
Anthony Rizzo.
Overrated. And he deals. That one's upstairs. Ball one. Ball one. Rizzo goes 6 feet, 3 inches. 34-year-old vet. And he was a sixth-round draft pick back in 2007. In the air out towards right center. Páez sizing this one up. Hauls it in for the out. Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. And ball one. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Brent Honeywell Jr. appears to be getting loose. Kicks and deals. Now fly ball to right center. Páez on the move to the alley. And a couple of quick outs.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Two outs, bases empty. And next for New York, Austin Wells. There's a line drive to left field. That's a hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
The left fielder, number 24.
Now the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. That missed by a lot. And that's ball one. Left-hand batter waits. That one ripped right center field, and that gets down into the gap. Wells around second, headed for third, coming home. He will score, and they lead by four.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Gleyber Torres.
Nope.
And that one,
ball one.
Cutting but missing down low. Verdugo stands at second with two gone. Right-hander kicks, deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And the right-hander deals. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. A run on two hits, and they leave one. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Yankees 5 and the Dodgers 1. Bottom of the sixth. Here's the second baseman, Chris Taylor.
The second baseman, Chris Taylor.
The pitch. Just missed.
Ball one, no strike.
And another ball. Check swing. Went around. Now two balls and a strike. And downstairs.
Three balls, one strike.
And he walked him.
Perfect.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
And that's a base hit. throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. Stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ball game.
Betts stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around. The Dodgers with a chance to get back into it here in the bottom of the sixth. Almost got him. He was looking to come up with the shutdown inning and off to a shaky start. Here's a 1-1. Foul ball there. Kicks and fires. Roll to short, could be two. Off balance beat, there's one. Plenty of time at first, that's a double play.
Got what he was looking for on the mound right there, and his infielders took care of business. Pretty textbook execution between short and second to turn that into two outs.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. And he swings over the top there.
0-1.
Two outs. Not close with that one. And a count 1-2. Check swing, no appeal. Next offering upstairs.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this.
And a swing and a miss. Inning over. So the Dodgers leave one. They're down 5-1. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Ryan Brazier.
Well, I got to think he probably has a little extra in the tank facing his former team. And there's not a player in the league that doesn't get a little extra motivation when he plays against his old squad.
Here's Juan Soto.
The designated hitter, Juan Soto.
And a pitch. Fastball in for a strike. 1-1.
You know, these Yankees digging into their numbers have to be happy with the swings they're taking.
They have 5 extra base hits on the stat sheet so far, and that tells me they're seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well.
Pulls up, and that's in there for a knock.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a long dart in there, and he found a way.
Judge at the plate and takes high there.
With all those extra base hits, it's easy to think we're going to see that trend continue the rest of the game. They seem to be really locked in at the plate.
That misses. Now 2-0. That catches the corner. Runner at first with no outs here. Here's a 2-2. Struck him out looking.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Hammered on a line into left, base hit. And the postseason success continues for him. Jazz Chisholm Jr. stepping in now for the Yankees. That's a bullet, but it goes foul.
To shorten your path to the baseball, put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
The 1-2. Fly ball down the line. Fair ball. Coming around third is Soto. On the third, save. And a run comes in to score.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. High fastball, even a little above the zone, but such a good job of staying tall on the backside, getting that barrel there to meet it just in time. I'll tell you what, it's not easy to do.
Anthony Rizzo will hit next. 0 for 3 with two strikeouts and a flyout. And the first offering is not close. At the belt and fires. Slider misses outside.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Traffic on the bases with one already in here in the late stages of game one. Here's Rizzo swinging a drive deep right field. One run across, bangs off the wall. Jazz on his horse coming around third. The relay to the plate. He'll score. Two runs are in. It's 8-1.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
Honeywell Jr. gets the call from the pen.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
One out, runner at second. And now Anthony Volpe, 1 for 3. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Drifts towards it. Calls it in, and there's two away.
The catcher, number 28, Austin.
And here's the catcher, Austin Wells. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Count 1-0.
Already three runs across in the frame here in the top half of inning number 7. To the right side. Oh, a great grab on the dive from his backside. Makes it himself, and he got him. Nicely done at first for the out.
First, it looks like making the stop is the hardest part, but feeding to the pitcher on the move, I think even tougher. Great job of hitting that moving target. They're going to be fired up in the dugout.
And we're back. Tommy Edmond at the plate. The pitch. That's a strike, and it's 0-1. Movement in the Yankees' pen. Luis Gil getting loose out there. Meza, the power lefty, up as well. As he swings through it.
So impressive how the velo is still there, even this deep into the outing.
And that's in the dirt.
Two strikes.
Up and in, and the count's even at 2. Swing and a ball popped up. Rizzo settles under it. One down.
Seems like the hitters are struggling with their timing today, kind of caught in between that sharp fastball and the nasty slider. I'd like to see him settle on a consistent pitch.
And now it's Max Muncy. That one's in there, 0-1. Base is empty, one away. Here at the bottom of the seventh. Rodon ready, the 0-2 on the way.
One ball, two strikes.
Just missed.
He missed the zone, but I don't think he missed his spot. That was a good pitch with two strikes.
Right side. Sizes this one up. And there are two down.
The third baseman, number eight.
So digging in, Enrique Hernandez. Strike one to Kike Hernandez.
Usually when a pitcher's had a dominant outing, he has filled up the strike zone and he's gotten ahead in the count with first pitch strikes. Well, that's exactly what this guy has done in this one. Over 70% first pitch strikes.
Next offering misses. Down one and two.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball.
Ouch, that one got him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch. So two down, and next for L.A., Andy Pajes. That one not close. Ball one. This one in the air, center field. Judge is under it. And that is that. One left for L.A. It's still an 8-1 ball game. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Daniel Hudson.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleeding and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
And now, Alex Verdugo.
The left fielder, number 24, Alex Verdugo.
And here it comes. And he takes a strike.
0-1 to count.
Strike two.
0-2 is the count.
Right-handed reliever. Called strike three on the fastball, and that ran back over the other half. Didn't agree with the call at the plate right there.
Again, a game like this, that's just too close to take. It's a blowout game. Guys have been out here for a while. Umpire's saying, hey, let's go. Cut it loose. Swing the bat.
So the lineup flips over, and now Gleyber Torres. Swing and a miss, blew it by him at 99. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Hernandez pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay close.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the DH, Juan Soto. First offering misses badly for ball one. Two down, nobody on. In there at the knees. And a count one and one. miss. Left-hand hitter waits. Wouldn't chase that time. Aaron Judge on deck for the Yankees. Two outs. A little out front there as he swings through it. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Yanks held in check, and it remains an 8-1 game. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Luis Gil.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
Here's the catcher, Will Smith.
The catcher, Will Smith.
The pitch. Just missed. Righty to the plate. And another ball. Goes down looking. Here comes Chris Taylor. Missed with a changeup, and that is ball one. Action in the pen down there. Jake Cousins getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. The Yanks up big in this one here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Next pitch is outside.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
One down, base is empty.
That's outside.
And there's the automatic. Hit in the air, right field. Stanton snags it. Two away.
Up next, the designated hitter.
Here's Kevin Kiermaier. And there's a strike. Good heater at 98. Misses inside, off the inside. Yeah, the count even, 1-1.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Yeah. That pitch in for a strike. 1-2. Swing and a miss, and that's that. Back here at Dodger Stadium, new inning getting started. And stepping in for the Yankees, Aaron Judge. The pitch. And ball one to Judge. Hudson, a 6-3 righty. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a changeup. And that's down and away.
2-0 count to a guy like this at the plate. You've got to throw a pitcher's pitch. Don't just try to get a strike. He could make you pay.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Two and one on Judge. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Stanton, the next to hit, takes ball one. The 1-0. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And it's a one hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. Cut off, throw to second, and he's there with a double.
With that fastball, even though it's high velocity, you've got to live on the outer edges. When it's right on a tee, right down the middle, professional hitters are not going to have a problem turning it around.
And up next for New York, Jazz Chisholm Jr.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Fastball for a strike.
0-1's the count.
Swing and a miss. Ugly swing right there.
0-2.
And it's second. And 1-2.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off speed's probably coming.
And a pitch. That misses the zone. And that's ball two.
Two balls, two strikes.
In the air out to center on his way over. And makes the grab. And there's two down.
Now back, the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
And here's the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
Drove it off the wall last time, just missed out on a home run.
Close one, doesn't get the call. And it's 1-0. On its way to the corner, Hernandez ranging after it. Reaches over the wall, and he's got it! So one hit is all they get. 2-3-4 set to hit in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Yankees 8, and the Dodgers 1. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Now here is Mookie Betts. The right-hander back to work.
The home team is hoping to find a way to rally, Boog, but the odds aren't in their favor. Safe to say game one isn't going the way they want it.
And Mookie takes. That's in there. And it's 1-2. And another ball. way outside, 3-2 now. Turns and fires to Betts. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. In the air, left field. And Betts is gone. And there's one down.
Now got left field. Payoff turn.
He's two outs away. Teoscar Hernandez, the next to hit. In there, and it's 0-1. And the pitch is outside, ball one. There's a strike. The Dodgers with a lot of ground to make up. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. Got him swinging.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. But what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
And he deals. Good eye in that spot. Sends it to center, and that's going to do it. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees take this one in a blowout.